Hey guys, this is just a quick video about how our book club will work. Enough people said they wanted to do a book club. I think it was like 20 or 30 people. I don't really remember the exact number. I'll put the poll up right here for all to view. So we will do a book club. It'll be online, obviously. Everybody is welcome if you're interested in being in a book club. I posted in my community tab a poll for the 5 books available for Book of the Month. So Book of the Month is a subscription. The reason I am recommending Book of the Month is because you can get the book so much cheaper, and they always have really good picks. Like I've been watching them for a little while, and every time I watch their 5 picks, they end up being pretty good. So they also pick across different genres. For example, this time there's a thriller, there's also romance, there's also nonfiction. So there's 5 different books in 5 different categories, and they are all posted on my community tab. If you want to be in the book club, you can go to the community tab and vote right now for what book you would like. 24 hours after this is posted, I'm probably gonna close it so everyone has enough time to get the book. The way you get the book is any way you want. You don't have to join Book of the Month Club. These books are available to anyone. So you could get it on Amazon, you could get it through Book of the Month. It will be way cheaper if you do it that way. You could get it through Audible if you want to listen to it instead of read it. You can get it through Kindle if you have a Kindle and that's just your preference. But we will all read the same book, and I'll create a little discussion board where we can post questions and comments, and people can talk in the discussion about what's going on in the part of the book that they're reading. I'll post whatever was posted in the discussion. I will post a video about that, about the book, my thoughts, what your guys' thoughts were. And if you guys want it to be anonymous, I don't have to share your names, but I could also share your names, completely optional, of course. The way you get to my community tab is to click on my profile. Just click on my little face down below, or where it says Everything Proof Beauty, you can click on that and it'll take you to my channel page. If you are on desktop, phone, and iPad, this all looks differently, and I only have tested it on phone and desktop, so I don't know if you can get to the community tab on iPad or not. But after you click me, you should be able to see little tabs, and those tabs, one of them will say community. When you click on that tab, there's a poll, and that's how you vote for what book we're gonna choose. I will also post on the community tab after we choose the book, and I'll post on my Instagram story. So if you guys follow me on Instagram and that's easier for you, you could just watch my story. We're all on lockdown, and some states are increasing restrictions. My state is one of the states increasing restrictions. So there's nothing like a good book when you are bored and have nothing else to do. So when your state is starting to close more things down and you are finding yourself at home a little bit more, it's a little fun way to escape in the book world. So let's go through the 5 books. I'm gonna do just a brief what it says online summary so that it's easier for you to vote in the community tab. The first book is called The Beauty in Breaking by Michelle Harper. This book says, forget Grey's Anatomy, here's the real story of an ER doctor's life, from injustice and heartbreak to healing and hope. It says, it is a heavy read, it is inspirational, it's a non-linear timeline, and it's literary. The synopsis says, Michelle Harper is a female African-American emergency room physician in a profession that is overwhelmingly male and white. Brought up in Washington, D.C. in an abusive family, she went to Harvard, where she met her husband. They stayed together through medical school, and 2 months later, she was scheduled to join the staff of a hospital in central Philadelphia. When he told her he couldn't move with her marriage at an end, Harper began her new life in a new city, in a new job, as a newly single woman. The second book is a thriller. It's called The Shadows by Alex North. The quick take says, ever repeat Bloody Mary in the mirror 3 times? This is the creeptastic thriller for urban myth believers. So it says, good to know, it's psychological, it's a detective book, scary, and suburban drama. The synopsis says, you knew a teenager like Charlie Crabtree, a dark imagination, a sinister smile, always on the outside of the group. Some part of you suspected he might be capable of doing something awful. 25 years ago, Crabtree did just that, committing a murder so shocking that it's attracted that strange kind of infamy that only exists on the darkest corners of the internet and inspired more than one copycat. The third book is horror. It's called Mexican Gothic by Silvia Moreno Garcia. This is in the horror category, which I don't know what the difference between thriller and horror is. But the quick take says, a new take on Gothic suspense that displays the horrors of colonialism against a dreamy, read nightmarish, backdrop. For the good to know section, it says it is a feminist book, movie-ish, supernatural, and creepy. And the brief synopsis, after receiving a frantic letter from her newlywed cousin begging for someone to save her from a mysterious doom, Naomi Taboada heads to High Place, a distant house in the Mexican countryside. She's not sure what she'll find. Her cousin's husband, a handsome Englishman, is a stranger, and Naomi knows little about the region. The fourth book is Head Over Heels by Hannah Orenstein, and this is a romance novel. It says, missing the 2020 Olympics, here's your fix of long-standing rivals, gymnastic routines, and inter-athlete love. Good to know, it is emotional, family drama, quirky, and millennial. It does say, this book contains themes of emotional and physical abuse, so if that is triggering to you, this might not be the book that you want to vote for. The synopsis says, the past 7 years have been hard on Avery Abrams. After training her entire life to make the Olympic gymnastic team, a disastrous performance ended her athletic career for good. Her best friend and teammate, Jasmine, went on to become an Olympic champion, then committed the ultimate betrayal by marrying their emotionally abusive coach, Dimitri. And their fifth pick is called Big Friendship. This is a non-fiction book by Aminato Sow and Anne Friedman. And I really apologize if I'm butchering those names. The quick take says, grab your BFF. This book explores female friendship from all angles, including its highs, lows, and rewarding feels. Good to know, it's a fast read, it's a famous author, social issues, and female friendship based. The brief synopsis says, a close friendship is one of the most influential and important relationships a human life can contain. Anyone will tell you that. But for all the rosy sentiments surrounding friendship, most people don't talk much about what it really takes to stay close for the long haul. So the way you get this book, you can get it through Book of the Month. I will link my referral link down below. If you want to join, that makes your first book $9.99 instead of $14.99. I guarantee all of these books are probably $16, $20, $25. The last book that I got from Book of the Month was $27 online, and I got it for $14.99. This is a subscription, but it's really easy to skip. I skipped last month, actually, so the book that I got was for the month of May, and I didn't get one for June, and now I'm getting one for the July month. You can, of course, look on Amazon. You can use your Kindle if you're a Kindle-type person. You can do it on Audible if you're not a reader, you're just a listener. That is fine, too. Everyone, all levels are welcome in this book club. And I just hope that we have a great time and a great discussion. And this is just a really cool way to connect. I had no idea this many people would be interested. It looks like our subscriber base has a lot of readers. And I can't wait to do this with you guys. So make sure you head to the community tab and that you vote. Again, you click on my little face or name down below, scroll over and click on the community tab. And the poll will be right there for you. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys later. Bye!